If you run an online business, chances are you've encountered this maybe more than once or twice. It is finding content ideas. Picture yourself just going around in circles every single day trying to find an idea for your Instagram, for your newsletter, for your blog. So I think now it's the right time to go back to the basics and talk about content pillars. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Bianca and I'm a content strategist and creator for small businesses and entrepreneurs alike. Now, before we get into the nitty-gritty of content pillars, let's start from the very beginning and ask ourselves what even is a content pillar, or people call it content buckets or content themes. Basically, it's 3 to 5 topics that your brand will consistently talk about or discuss on your social media platforms or on your website or a newsletter. Finding your content pillars will gain so much clarity and it will help your ideal audience find you quicker on your social media. So once they hop onto your page, they'll be able to see within the first, 6 posts what you're all about and how you'll be able to help them. How can I constantly find ideas every single week? Most importantly, this crucial step will dramatically save time in your content creation process and finding ideas for your page. What do I talk about on my social media? So the first thing that we have to establish is, how do you find your content pillars? How do you figure out what to talk about and what your main content pillars will be? Let's give a quick example of what this might look like. Say you are a wedding photographer and you have a wedding photographer Instagram, you have your Facebook page, you have your website, everything is all set up. And so now it is time to figure out what your content pillars are. So your content pillars might look like something like this. You will have a content pillar that is more personal and that is about you, so things that are specifically to you. You'll have a content pillar that is maybe about photography tips on how to, shoot effectively on your page. You might want to be something more educational, or you might want to have a content pillar that is wedding specific. Say you want to talk about wedding tips to help your bride on the day of their wedding. So maybe you'll have that. Another content pillar could be just client testimonials or just client love. So anything that your clients have loved about you or have raved about you, or you want to show pictures of your work, that is another really important content pillar to have so that you can gain trust with your target audience. So that's why it is super important to recognize who your brand is, who you are, what you want to be known for, and that'll kind of navigate where you want to go in terms of content themes and ideas. How do I make everything make sense and be cohesive? Now that you have your content pillars established, how are you ever going to use it? How do you effectively use your content pillars the right way? So you might want to use any sort of platform that you have, or a simple Google sheet would suffice, where you list out all of your content pillars in columns, then you'll list out all of your content ideas within each pillar. But it doesn't really stop there, because you can also have hashtag research within each content pillar and keyword research. So you can have 3 separate pages where you do the research on each of these content pillars. And then once you're ready to post, or once you're ready to start your content creation process, then it's really just a simple plug and play of taking the idea, taking the hashtags that are related to that idea, and then taking that keywords for whatever platform you like to use, whether it's YouTube, whether it's Pinterest or Instagram. So yeah, that is really the most effective and easiest way to really pick and choose what you need for the month. Another really important thing to remember is to take into consideration the time of year and the current events that are going on within that time. So say it's a holiday or a theme day, you'll want to really incorporate your content into those types of themes, and that'll be really helpful for you to get into the trends and the current events that are going on right now. You've got this. In the end, you and your brand are ever changing, and so things might change or evolve throughout the year, and that's okay, and that is really just the discovery or exploration process. And so have fun with it and discover what you really love to talk about and what your audience really likes to hear. And that is the perfect combination you need for your content strategy. I hope you enjoyed this quick introduction to content pillars. Let me know if you'd like to know more in the future. Make sure to follow me on Instagram at itsbiancarealm and subscribe to this channel if you want to see any other of these wonderful videos. I have a video every single Thursday. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye!